to Jamaica.
Okay, we're...
The next station is Amagansett.
Today is Saturday, July 30th, 2022. We're on train 8709, waiting to depart from Montauk. We're going to ride this as far as Patchogue. Locomotive's got the LIRR DM30AC518. Trailing unit is 519. 518 has the Salvation Army bell, which I don't like, but it has probably the best sounding K5LA horn on the railroad. And Spaghetti and Meatballs promised to put on a good show for me with that. 3:30, right on the button, we're departing Montauk. Yeah, I came out on 8706 and Spaghetti had engine 521 on the point and he was kind of blowing lightly with the horn, and I later found out from him, because he normally blows pretty good, he said the high pitched bell on that horn was giving him an earache. So, like screech, like chalk on a blackboard, he says. So. Okay, I'll accept that. But with this one, the 518, he promised to put on a really good show. Over there is the Montauk Y. This is MY. They use that Y once in a while. Gorgeous day. I was here about 2.5 hours. Had a nice leisurely walk to town. Nice lunch, walk back. Like I said, what this town really should do for people who ride the train here is to provide like a free shuttle service from here to the village and to the lighthouse. It would be a boon for tourists coming out here by train. While I was walking to town there, I had a lot of company, and many of them were not happy about making the walk. And cab fares are exorbitant. Change sides on this train depending on the sun angles. Trail State Park. It's just thick woodlands here. Very remote. Sort of reminds me of the Port Jefferson Branch. Crossing in these woods. It's a dirt road for hikers. On the back. This is Spaghetti and Meatballs Monday. He's off on Thursday and Friday. He does this round trip to Montauk on Saturday and Sunday, 8706 and 8709 back. And on Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, he does 2772 Jamaica-Patchogue, and a deadhead to Babylon, and 2738 to Spionk, and I think 8743 back, or 2743 back to Jamaica. Should get a nice view over here in a minute. Chairs with this train. The curved sun angle is on one side to the other. Straightaway for quite a few miles, paralleling 27 and beaches off to the left. that's a great horn. You hear me brag about the K5LA horns, but that gets honorable mention. It's the best non-K5LA horn on the railroad. See those buildings over there, lodges, homes. Ocean Beach is right on the other side. Sound. And New York Route 27 parallels us there, Sunrise Highway. Runs all the way out east to Montauk Point. Trees between us and the road. When I was a kid, the road was completely exposed. Shows you how much it's grown over the years. Yeah, back in November 1967, they ran steam out here. Black River and Western number 60. Baldwin built. Still serves on the Black River and Western Railroad today. Ran out to Montauk that day, flawlessly. On the way back, it conked out somewhere west of Babylon. Had to be towed in. I was at Jamaica waiting for it to come in. I never saw it. I only saw it stop on the way home. My dad, and we live in Lindenhurst, where there were a lot of railroad crossings back then, said that thing was blasting his whistle like a banshee going through town. Wish I could have been there to hear it. Coming into Amagansett, you'll see the siding at AG. Asian Army bell ringing. That's the downside of this locomotive. Yeah, I think I better go to the other side. Nice golf course in Amagansett. The golfers are definitely having a lot of fun today. It's a great golfing day. Thing about golfing is you have to be careful. If it's a humid day, you're susceptible to thunderstorms, and golf clubs make excellent lightning rods. A lot of people playing golf have been struck by lightning, but on a day like today, there's no worries. Stations on the Long Island Railroad that are under a three-digit milepost number.
This is the train to Jamaica. The next station is East Hampton.
Greenport doesn't quite make it. It's about 94 something. Distance you can travel on an on-Amtrak train anywhere in the continental United States presently. That will change when Brightline to Orlando starts. The sun angles are driving me nuts. They keep changing based on the direction the rails follow. busy Newtown Lane, driving East Hampton. Siding here, used for maintenance away today, but years ago that was part of HN siding, black lemon. Over New York, Route 114, East Hampton, Greenport Highway. Part of the route is on two ferry boats. Challenger 3985. horns over the years, but this is the sweetest. The very first K5LA horn I ever heard was back in 1977 on Long Island Railroad, brand new GP38-2 number 277. Never heard anything like it. It was practically killing to get that locomotive on tape. There have been so many variations of K5LA since then that they've become almost boring, but this one has an extra special, rich, mellow sound. K5LAs, 405, 418. Southampton. We'll pass by the old depot at Watermill, now a business. Beautiful white columns. Says he has a problem going fast between Bridgehampton and Southampton. He's limited to reduced speed because of his ASC. Between that and PTC, it's a nightmare sometimes when on trains. blueprint. Coming into Southampton.
This station is Southampton.
Is SH3. No, that was actually SH2. SH1 is at the west end. Always got a kick out of this long canopy at this station. SH1 signal. Southampton Village Police. This white building over here, years ago, used to be John Duck's restaurant. We used to go out there like once a month with my grandparents. That delicious duck dinner.
This is the train to Jamaica. The next station is Hampton Bay.
Development over here, and they're still building. Southampton College. This is the site of the old Southampton College station at the crossing. this side now. The other side's getting full. Under Route 27A, Montauk Highway. PK3. Coming into Hampton Bays. Like SH, this is one of the newer controlled sightings they have east of Spionk. Before this was put in, it used to be a black limit station called ND. Life has gotten a lot easier with these automated switches and signaling. Cuts down on the delays of trains. Before that, you had to throw switches manually, fill out K cards. Took a lot of time. All of that stuff is eliminated now. Leaving Hampton Bays. Signal for RPK2. In the summer, 2708 and 2709 meet here. RPK1. Down there. Approaching the double crossings. Two crossings right next to each other. there. On the old Quag station site. It was discontinued in the late 90s. It's a sharp right-hand curve here. Christmas spirit a little early. So many railroads are getting bells like that. The engineer said that the new engines that come will get those same bells, so I better get used to them. They're everywhere. New England Central has them. Via Rail Canada has them. Give me the chrome bell any day. The best bell of all was the Pennsylvania Railroad brass bell. You heard them on the GG1s. Thank you. Okay, a lot of love is at this station tonight. Next stop, Spionk. Teen's horn is the real star on this video. I wasn't planning on videotaping on the way back, but when I heard that 518 was on the front, it was a no-brainer. Things about riding on a train is having a great horn on the locomotive and a cooperative engineer blowing it. Niagara Road, east end of Spionk, entering SK2. Milepost 71. Spionk, and now it's a local restaurant. Spionk Station. It's a cab car, but we're coupled right behind the locomotive. Straight ahead would have taken you to Manorville on the main line. 77A, Montauk Highway. This is East Mauritius. Mauritius Depot of old. And pretty soon we'll be coming up to the great Santa Mauritius horn storm. He promised to put on a good show. There's like 7 railroad crossings. Station site in the Forge River. Pretty close together. Station site discontinued to 98. Field Brewing Company. The Forge River. Thank you. thumping over JJD2. Old MS into locking. Passengers will board here. That wasn't the case on a trip I took on this train back in the spring. Boarding Mastic Shirley, next stop Billport. Here we stop. Alright, here we go again. Floyd Parkway. I miss the Windmill Diner. Used to eat here a lot. Turned into a bank.
This is the train to Jamaica. The next station is Belfort. Painters.
Station Road, arriving Belfort, Grand Central Terminal. Here I leave in Belfort, next stop Patchogue, where I'll detrain. Spaghetti and meatballs didn't disappoint with this one. Great job. Queens, approaching the Ocean Avenue crossing before Patchogue station arrival. Ocean Avenue, Patchogue. And porta potties where the old PD tower used to be.
And this was at the end of the night. And when I had turned for a second, I saw all these people, including a lady and her son, very distant. It was like, I remember there was a commercial, everyone was heading somewhere, and they all in the circle, and there's nobody else in the train. That's how they were all standing. They were so amazed.
As spaghetti and meatballs fades off into the sunset, he put on a great horn show with that engine. The police took him. Three cops took a person off the train here.